Okay, I'm going to show you where to download the IDE and get it set up. Let's open up a search. Type in Cube IDE download. Hit enter. We want this one right here at the ST.com link at the top. That's going to take us to the website. Now, in order to download any software from the ST.com site, you're going to have to register and log in. If you don't have a login yet, you'll have to create one, and then you can download the software. Now, I've already got myself logged in on this page here. Click on Get Software. Down here at the bottom is the Windows installer. Now, there are other installers, but this course will not be covering those installations. Click Accept. And then down here you can see that we're going to be downloading 625 megabytes. And the ST site can be pretty slow to download from. In fact, it could take up to 10-15 minutes to download the entire file. What I'm going to do is I'm going to cancel the download because I already have it downloaded right here. And when you click it, open, what you will have is a zip file to extract. If I say extract all, I've already done that. And this is what it looks like when it's extracted. I'm going to click that open. And this is the application to install the IDE. I'm going to go ahead and click this open. And there is a screen that asks me if I want to install the program. Now I'm going to click Next, Agree, Next, Install. Now this installation can take 5 minutes or so. There is so many files in that 625 megabytes to extract, so we're going to speed up through this. Okay, now that the entire file extracted and installed itself, I'm going to click Next. I'm going to say go ahead and create a desktop icon, Finish. And here is my IDE program. I'm going to go ahead and open it. And it's asking to create a workspace. So I'm going to go ahead and go with the default that it's providing and click Launch. I'm going to say no thanks right now. And I'm going to go ahead and maximize this. I'm going to close the Information Center. And that way we can see our workspace here. What we have over here is we have a default choices of what we want to do. Create a new STM32 project is what we're after. But we can also go up here in this corner. Don't click on the plus sign because you'll end up opening this. That's not what we want. Click over next to the folder, the little down arrow. And then you can click on STM32 project. And you're going to have to give it a moment. Shows it's going to open the target selector. And again, you need to be patient. Sometimes you think the thing's freezing up, but it's not. It's just, this is a very complex program, and it takes time to load everything up. Now, if I maximize this, we're going to lose this stuff, and it's going to have to think about where everything needs to go again. But just give it a moment. Okay. Now, what we're after is the STM32F4 family. So, you have board selector, you have example selector. What we want is the MCU selector. STM32F4, and the chip that we use is the 411 CE, right here. And the one we're after is the CEUX. Not CEUY, CEUX. If you just click on the 411 CE, it'll go ahead and highlight that one for you. Now, when you do that, you're going to have a data sheet link up here. If you click that, it'll go ahead and open up the PDF file. It gives you some information about that microcontroller. This one here is very important, especially when you go into initial designing. This shows how everything is connected together, the peripherals on the buses. Anyway, that's where that's found. Go ahead and close that. Go back to the IDE. There's also documents and resources that you can download. These are other examples and discussions about other things you can do with a microcontroller. And the main page is the features. And this gives you a quick rundown of everything that's inside of this microcontroller. For us, some of the main things that we're after is 512 kilobytes of flash, 128 kilobytes of RAM. Let's see here. We have DMA. We have I2C, UARTs, I2S, and SPI peripherals, and those are some of the most important parts that we need in order to make our synthesizer. Let's click Next. Then it's going to ask us to give it a project name. I'm just going to quickly give this one the name BP Synth. We're just going to walk through what would happen if we were to start a project. And what it's going to want to do is it's going to want to download some files for this family of processor. So I'm going to click Finish. Yes, we want to open this perspective now. And the IDE is going to want to download at least two files, it looks like here. One of the files is probably around 600 megabytes, and the other one's around 100 so megabytes. And to shorten this video, we're going to speed through this process because it takes several minutes for this to download, then unzip the file, then download the second file, and unzip it as well. So why don't we speed through this and get to the end of it. Once we get to this point, we are actually looking at a representation of the chip that we are using. And down here at the bottom, I can zoom in or press Control and use the mouse wheel to zoom in and out. And this is how we begin to configure the microcontroller for what we want it to do. To configure is kind of like you're getting your basic system down to what you're going to use for the chip. And in this case, we're going to be using PA3, PA4, PA5, and PA7. PA3 will be our MIDI port. 4, 5, and 7 will be connected to our digital analog converter. And that's essentially all we're really hooking up to this, besides power. And we have a crystal oscillator that we'll use to drive the timing of the microcontroller. We will come back to this. I just wanted to show you how we get this all downloaded and ready to be used. In another video, we will go over the pins and how we start to program our microcontroller to be ready to be used to be programmed. So you, in a way, you're programming it to program it. What we use this is to create code to configure the microcontroller for use of the way we want to use it. That's all we need to know for now. We'll return to this in another video.